Hello viewers, welcome to Motocraft here on Urban TV. And in our first segment, of course, we are looking at the independence cars. Uganda got its independence in 1962, and during that time we had a number of vehicles on road. We had the VW Beetle, as we introduced it in the last program. And in today's program, we are winding up on the VW Beetle and also look at a bit of Peugeot. The Peugeot or Peugeot is one of the cars that took center stage in Uganda till about the early 90s with their popular 504 as well as the 505 vehicles. Well, I believe that some of you are going to have their memory refreshed, and others who did not see these kinds of cars will also have to see them on this show and also appreciate where Uganda is coming from. As we speak today, most of those models of the cars have changed to modern vehicles. Of course, from the traditional technology to the electronic technology. Well, enjoy the show. The old VW Beetle has the following specifications: a 1000 to 1300 cubic capacity engine, a rear mounted engine that is air cooled, 4-seater capacity vehicle where you can put 2 adults at the front and 2 children at the rear. The old VW is a rear wheel drive vehicle, having its engine mounted at the rear at the same time the driving wheels. It has got a front cab boot. At the same time, the boot has a provision where the fuel tank is located. The old VW Beetle is a carburetor operated engine which uses petrol and has a 4-speed gearbox with a reverse gear. The old VW has a separate chassis and body, of which when weighed together it weighs 820 kilograms. The new VW Beetle has the following specifications, as it looks even much more different from the old VW Beetle, though it maintains the Beetle kind of appearance. It has a 1.8 liter fuel injection system engine, which is different from the original carburetor engine as found on the old Beetle. And when it comes to the interior, it has got a digital clock, a rev counter, commonly and technically called the tachometer, front and rear floor mats. It has active headrests, cup holders, temperature display, outside temperature gauge, a trip mechanism that can help you to count down your mileage easily, a 6-speed automatic gearbox with a manual mode, a front mounted engine with water cooled facility. The new VW has a lot of features that do not feature on the old VW models. And today, as we speak, there are many people owning the new version VW, and yet there are very few people who still maintain the old VW Beetle. Alman Peugeot became interested in the automobile early on, and after a meeting with Gottlieb Daimler and others, was convinced of its viability. The first Peugeot automobile, which was a three-wheeled steam-powered car designed by Léon Sapolet, was produced in 1889. Only four examples of that car were made. Steam power was heavy and bulky and required lengthy warm-up times. In 1890, after meeting Daimler and Emil Levasseur, steam was abandoned in favor of a four-wheeled car with a petrol-fueled internal combustion engine built by Panhard under Daimler license. The car was more sophisticated than many of its contemporaries, with a three-point suspension and sliding gear transmission. More cars followed: 29 built in 1892, 40 built in 1894, 72 built in 1895, 156 built in 1898, and 300 were built in 1899. These early models were given type numbers. Peugeot therefore became the first manufacturer to fit rubber tires or solid tires rather than pneumatic to a petrol-powered car. By 1910, Peugeot product line included in 1,149 cubic centimeter in a two-cylinder and six-cylinder and four cylinders of between 2 and 6 liters. In addition, a new factory opened in the same year at Sussex, which became the main plant in 1928. During the First World War, Peugeot turned largely to arms production, becoming a major manufacturer of the arms and military vehicles, from armored cars and bicycles to shells. In 1946, the company restarted car production with 202 units, delivering 14,000 copies. In 1947, Peugeot introduced the Peugeot 203 with coil springs, rack and pinion steering, and hydraulic brakes. The 203 set new Peugeot sales record, remaining in production until 1960s, by the time Uganda received her independence. Popular models introduced in 1955 was the Peugeot 403, which had a 1.5-liter engine. In 1960, Peugeot introduced a Peugeot 404, which used a 1,618 cubic capacitor engine, tilted at 45 degrees. The 404 proved rugged enough to win the East African Safari Rally four times. That was in 1963, 1966, 1967, 1960, and 1968. And 504 came on the scene by the end of the 60s. In 1980s and the 90s, Peugeot launched a successful Peugeot 205 Mi Super Mini, which is largely credited for turning the company's fortunes around. The 205 was regularly the best-selling car in France and was also very popular in other parts of Europe, including Britain, where sales regularly topped 50,000 units a year by the late 1980s. It won plaudits for its styling, ride and handling. It remained a sell in many markets. Until 1998, overlapping with the introduction of the 106 in 1991 and ceasing production at the launch of the 206, which also proved hugely popular across Europe. The popular Peugeot model that best sold in Uganda during the time and after independence was Peugeot 404, Peugeot 203, Peugeot 504, and later run in the early 90s Peugeot 505.